Good day. I'm back for another video. Return to Drain Lake, Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin playthrough. And I'm going to start this video by checking out some pyromancy stuff.
Hello again.
So I'm kind of thinking, besides maybe getting this flame quartz ring, let me check, see the orange burrs. I have one. I'm gonna buy one more and possibly flash sweat as well.
I'm always here.
First, let me see if I can equip a pyromancy flame. To make a choice between the flesh sweat or so I'm gonna use one or the other. I haven't really been too thrilled with magic weapon. It's probably just because my intelligence and magic aren't high enough, so it's not really getting much scaling. So I might end up respecing with a soul vessel to put those points into strength and dex instead of intelligence and faith and attunement, because I put a lot of points into those. So let's see. So basically, this raises my, supposedly raises my fire defense up like crazy. I see fire defense 48. I know it's supposed to be higher than that right now, but I'm gonna go ahead and respec it, things betwixt.
Still determined as ever, I see. Do you wish to start all over again?
Okay, so I know I want that where it was. So I got 11 points to play with. I'll put okay. So I'm going to be giving up the ability to use magic weapon, but honestly, I'll take the just pure defense and higher dex for the slightly stronger bow. Alright.
Now,
let me check my fragrant branches. I might just go ahead and grab, I might use the fragrant branch on this guy in here because I can get an Estus shard. Okay, I've got 5. Yeah, I'll go ahead and do this. I get the Estus shard. And I'm gonna get Twinkling Titanite, and I'm also gonna get the large petrified something from after we finish lighting the sconces. Okay. So there's a... It's an archer that you kind of have to watch out for. I'm gonna go ahead and light this one. Fire Drake Stone. So that means I can finally infuse with fire. You definitely want to take out these guys from a distance, because those three basilisks can easily petrify you. And this guy popping arrows at you can just kind of make things just a pain to deal with, all of them. All right. There we go. Okay, I'll have one poison arrow. That stinks. What? Oh, I forgot I lit all the sconces. So that's... Oh, crap. That's the invader that I was talking about coming at you when you light all the sconces. Walk off the edge. Deal with.
There we go.
And the reason I decided to go to this one was because you get a lot more for that fragrant branch than you would in the area down below where it's flooded in Hyde's Tower, where the other guy was petrified. You still get your Estus shard from that area, but that's pretty much all you get. So, all right, here we go. Start dropping stuff here. Okay, not a bad haul right there. That's not bad. And one other thing to note, the coffin out there changes your gender if you examine it. So it's kind of interesting that they let you change that. They let you respec. Don't let you change your physical appearance, to my knowledge, but so okay. Let's see. Let's head back to Majula because we gotta upgrade the Estus.
Is that here to see light? However, bearer.
Okay. Let's see. I want to go and see Strayed in the Bastille again. I want to see what these new boss souls can get me. So I kind of think I want to get the Pursuer Sword. Okay, we've got this bent blade. I said we have some boss souls give you spells. Toxic mist. I think that the toxic mist that that was her name sells, the pyromancy girl that we gave clothes to, I think that she sells it, and the rat vanguard soul is worth more than what it, we would get more pop in that soul than it would just to use it to buy this, so I'm gonna hold off for now. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and get Pursuer's Ultra Great Sword. And let's see. Maybe the Dragon Rider's bow. The problem with this is that it's really slow firing. I don't know how its range is. I mean, it would, out of the gates, it would be doing, without upgrading, it would be doing more damage than my current bow, so we'll go ahead and grab it. See what happens. And the bone slide, it looks like it's got great scaling, but the problem with it is that I probably wouldn't like the moveset, so we'll go ahead and shut up. Okay, let's check out that Ultra Great Sword for the Pursuer. Prepare for the wait. Ooh, good lord. The wait. Okay. So let's see how it compares with my claymore. It's stronger than the claymore right out of the gates. So let's see how the scaling damage, 290, 105. Well, hang on. That's about, it seems like it's neck and neck. I'm not sold on the moveset though, not yet at least. We might give this a shot. Okay, and then my bow is doing 208 versus 294. That's what's up. I bet this thing weighs a ton too. Let's see what the accuracy is like. What can I shoot at? Let's try and shoot at that corpse. Oh wow, it has no range. Okay, I'm not gonna touch the aiming stick. I'll give it a shot, but I probably will switch back. Alright, now this. Oh, wow, I forgot about the carry weight. Okay, let's dump this. Boy, we are. Okay. Oh my gosh. It's so heavy. Oh, there we go. Okay, time to go buy some arrows. Let's see what this would do to my scaling. So right now, B and C. Really not a whole lot. I don't have any bolt stones, but I want to go kind of use it first, and then we'll see if it. I think it takes twinkling titanite or dragon bones. Dragon bones. I'm not going to do anything until I know if whether or not I'm going to use this for good. I'm sold on this. Heavy attack, 397, 308. I mean, I know it's gonna do a lot more damage once I upgrade it, but. And those dragon bones are virtually impossible to come by. It's a tough call right here. I'm gonna keep keep using it just to kind of mess around with a little bit more. So we'll see what's next. We've got Iron Keep is next. And the wind up on this thing also is pretty terrible in terms of just overall speed. I tried. I want to get that shield out though. Their armor is pretty cool. It's not the best stuff in the game, but it looks really cool. Just whip whap right away. Alright, let's see. I think we might get our second invasion here. I'm trying to figure out. There we go. Armor Dennis. What up, Dennis? Fool. Fire, because it's a fairly long hike to the next bonfire. It's not really long distance, it's just a ton of guys between here and the bonfire, and not particularly weak guys either. First piece of Alone armor, and it is, so basically we'll get to kind of look like them. It's not the lightest stuff in the world, but here we go. A couple of tricks in this area, not a lot, but there is kind of one rather big one. So, despite weighing more, it's not as good as the RS helmet. So, it kind of I'm sure by now you've picked up on the theme. You picked up on the theme of this particular set of armor that I went to the... Alright, here we go. So this is why I bought a lot of arrows, because there are a lot of these guys. Oh, they shoot the big in Orlando arrows. And they're fast. As you can see, they're significantly faster than the regular arrows. Ooh. Boy, this shield feels like it takes an ages to parry. Those guys are actually not too hard to parry, but I guess if you have a big shield or bigger shield. Okay. So now there's a couple of guys up there. There's another guy by the fog gate way over there. But he's one of the captains. And he has quite a bit more health. So sniping him from here would probably just get me killed. Try not to get the archer upset. There's another one right there. All right. First things first, I'm going to lower half of the bridge here. And there's a switch on the other side that will drop the other half. And right now, this is death waiting for you. So ordinarily, to get that couple of nights, you could just drop down here and then it would take you up to this third level. And you would get to them from here, but it's easier to just shoot them with arrows. A twinkly goodness. Alright, it's time to go pull the other switch, but first I'm gonna see if I can aggro one or two of these guys. So when you hit one, it pulls them both. One more, come on. Yes. Okay. Well, what have we here? Wait a minute. He fell down on the platform. Well, he can't get me, so... can fall in the lava. Alright, this guy can ruin your day because those great arrows can actually knock you off this bridge, so I'm gonna have to be careful here. So I think I'm out of his line of fire. Alright. That is everyone, I believe. Nope, there's one guy right there. I forgot about him. Oh, two. All right. Boy, their pathfinding needs some work. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and turn this. Turns the fire off. This drops down the other half of the bridge. Petrified dragon bone. It's very good. Just in case I changed my mind on that. Or end up with a different weapon that uses it, which I don't think that I am right now, at least. Okay, so you have two options here. I'm gonna go ahead and double back here because there's some stuff I didn't get yet. There's an optional boss in that circular area right there, which we'll fight him, but I want to go ahead and get one more bonfire before I do. There's kind of a large chunk of enemies between here and the bonfire. So we've got Lucatiel's summon. Oh, I could have sworn they pulled you out of the DLC, out with the DLC. All right, Captain Helm, and this jump right here can be pretty. Oh yes, another boon. All right, now I don't know. I think that that sword is just so slow. I mean, it's not really about the damage. It's just about the slow speed of it. I think that's what's bugging me, is that I can't get my attacks off fast enough. So let's see here. I'm gonna go ahead and here, literally. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and proceed onward and grab that bonfire. So this guy, I'll go ahead and he basically starts pounding on the iron. Well, I guess they changed it, maybe? He used to pound on the bridge and create a hole. Like, he would smash this and one of these would be empty. So this area can kind of be a little bit tricky because there's a lot of attacks coming at you from one area. Mainly the archers. I'll say that now, but Oh, it's too slow. Oh, great. Oh, so this is kind of what I was... I brought this upon myself. Steel katana. I don't think I got that drop last time. Okay, there's another one over there in that corner right there. And I believe there is crystal lizard. Oh, what? Oh, they changed his location. He used to be like right here. Okay. Well, today I learned. Okay, let's see. There's some more guys I can kind of pick off from here. Gonna hit the chains? Nope. I'm gonna try this again. Try to get this guy again. It kinda sucks at that. Oh, wait, it doesn't. He won't go on that one. It kind of sucks that that thing doesn't come up glowing red. Come on. All right, now for the secret. I guess it's not really that big of a secret since it uses a lockstone, but it's a very valuable lockstone. Absolutely want to have one for this area. It's got more lightning protection swag. And a bonfire. But yeah, I'm definitely taking these 50,000 souls back. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and slip on up here and look who it is. This is the other bell tower.
Yeah!
Sit down. Okay, let's see. We got a couple more of the little guys. See how fast that comes out of his arrows? Really fast. Oh, I wanted to jump. That's probably aggro this dude, yep. Did he try to parry me? Yep. I'm gonna see if I can parry him. Look at that stupid fat roll. Come on, dude. So you've got ballistas that you can kind of use if you want to. This guy again. There's one more of those big heavy armor guys over here. I forgot about the dunk. Oh, the elevation. It's kind of like Dark Souls 1 where if you're on stairs you can't riposte. You can still parry, but the riposte animation won't trigger because you're at a different elevation than the person that you're trying to riposte. That item we just picked up, the Cyclops snake trooches. I believe these are the anti-petrify ones that I was thinking I was using in the Rat Covenant boss fight, but alas, I was not. I was mistaken. So we're back here. Just kind of loops back around, and let's see. There's one more bonfire I want to get. Oh crap, I'm out of arrows. I'm headed back. More arrows, please. Yeah, I definitely want more arrows, because that room can just get overwhelming really fast. And I remember my first time through, I really struggled in that room because I was not using arrows at all. I'm not ready to upgrade this yet, because I still might end up with the Murakumo, just because of how stinking strong that thing is when it's at plus 10. Like, it has S scaling, I believe. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and buy it from Ornifex. Again. So if you haven't guessed already, those guys are everywhere in this game. The Forlorn are a common invader. Let's see if she's got any extra boss weapons. I think I've already been... Well, no. Spider Fang, that's a new one. It's okay. That's all she got. All right. Oh, wait. This is a... Oh, crap. This is a... Well, I guess it won't matter. This might turn into a Dex build. Okay. Let's see. Yeah. This... So let's see, hang on, at plus one. So we got 290 and 109. And Murakumo has... So it's only 90 behind at this point. Let's go ahead and take this thing. $290, $109, $380, and $99. gives us a difference of 80. And the weapon, the moveset for this thing is just sweet. So, it is a heavier weapon. But let's see here. 72. What can I remove? Okay. And look at this thing. Okay, I need one or two more points and to my stamina. It's got the overhead slam for tight quarters. I get the one thing that I do kind of miss is that cheap shot is the stab. You don't get that the counter damage, like, because you can stack the claymore with the Leo ring and get more damage out of it. So, but I still don't think that it can match the damage output of this thing. Back to the Iron Keep. Actually, let me look up the location of the plus one Fire Quartz ring, because I'm going to need that. Okay, field trip back to the Forest of the Fallen Giants. It is in the Salamander Pit. So these guys, they hit pretty hard. They have very explosive fire attacks, but you can cheese them like this. So I'm going to put the Chloranthi ring on. And believe me, you absolutely want to go ahead and take care of those guys. Let's see, the other one I believe is... They may have moved him. Okay. So I'm gonna put my cat ring on. Ring. Lovely. It's gonna make our arrows more powerful. I might go ahead and just throw some fire infusion on this thing. On the Murakumo. Is There we go. So this greatly increases my fire defense. And it's time to head on out. Right here, come on! Come on, kill me! Oh. There we go. Well, if nothing else, we can sell this stuff to Gavlin. The danger with trying to run in for a melee kill on this guy is that you've got the other captain waiting for you to the right. And so it's it's dangerous to run at him because you'll get hit from behind. Plus there's the two guys up above on that ledge. So as long as you kind of just take this slow and methodical. Okay, so the kicker with this fight is that this dude hits extremely hard. It's the Smelter Demon. He hits extremely hard, and his final phase, he does pure fire damage. And that's why I've been kind of collecting some of this fire defense stuff. Let me see what this... Fire defense 30. Oh, there it is. That's what the little icon was. That's what I was looking for. So a hefty bonus to my fire defense. And let's see, I'm gonna go ahead and keep the armor for the physical defense. And the pyromancy. Wait a minute. Did I only get one use out of that? That's weird. I thought I was gonna get one use per bonfire. Oh. If I get killed by this guy, then I'll reinvestigate that one. For now, though, this will stack with the fire ring to further boost my defense. And this puts me over the weight limit. Let's just give this a shot. Swap this out real quick. Okay. Here we go. Okay. Tell if he was hitting me or not. I know I took one hit there while I was Estusing, and it really didn't do a whole lot. Yeah, so he can be a real butthole if your fire defense is low. But anyways, fairly uneventful, and we've continued Lucatiel's quest line by summoning her. Scene's shield. I got a checkpoint. Let's see if I can attune. Okay, I get it. So I lost my attunement slot for the flash sweat when I took those stat points away. I see. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna worry about it. Really not too big of a deal. That's probably the only area I was gonna make any kind of significant use out of it, but the small orange burr does not stack with the flash sweat, so it really wouldn't have made too much of a difference. Flash sweat does way more than the orange burr, by the way. So okay, let's see. Let me double check. I think this thing is dex based. I'm almost positive. Alright, we got an A in dex. I'm just gonna start dumping everything into that now. Oh, wait. I'm gonna put one into vigor or vitality. No, yeah, endurance. So what happens? See if I get that fifth swing. That's what I'm wanting. Nope. Let's try one more point. One more. I really want to get five swings without having to rely on
Bearer of the curse.
The dragon ring. Hopefully it does it this time. I got a feeling that it won't be enough. Okay. I'll put a couple more in there, and if it still doesn't do it, then I'll kind of reevaluate. Actually, how many more levels, more souls do I need to level up? I think I can pop a couple of boss souls here. Seek lest this. So I need about. Let's see, I'll go ahead and get 17k for this next level. I don't need this. So I think if this doesn't do it, I'm just gonna just be okay with four swings until I get the dragon ring. Oh well, okay. The dragon ring's gonna give me health as well, so it's kind of one of those no-brainers that you want to take. Tracking is kind of weird on some of these weapon heavy swings. I know the Great Club just infuriated me with some of its poor tracking. Let's drag this guy out here. Forgot about you. Oh, when will I learn? Fat roll, no. 0.3. Okay. Okay. See if I can get that crystal lizard over there also. Can he hit me here? Okay, so I bet I can snipe him. I'm gonna have to. What? Come on. It's one of the most frustrating parts of this game. Oh, dang it, idiot. Stupid lizard. These pressure plates right here drop the platforms. FYI, you can use it to your advantage if people are chasing you, or if you've lured an enemy onto the platform and you're up here. You can just drop them on down. So there's another item over here I'm gonna get, and also be aware there are pressure plates here that will turn on a molten iron flow from these cauldrons. There's three of them. And If you have fire protection, flash sweat, the ring, etc., then you can get that. And there's another, that other one at the beginning of this area. And as you can imagine, this does a lot of damage, and you can bait several of the enemies to chase you over to this area, to that corner, and you just run across the pressure plates, and the molten iron will just kill all of them. So it's a easy way to kind of cheese the guys if you don't use the arrow method. See how fast that guy's attack was. You kind of have to, you gotta get that timing just right, because I mean, they're so fast. And I'm gonna go ahead and get one more bonfire before even attempting. We have here. Ah, slow attack. We got a bunch of stuff we're going to be selling to Gavlin here. Okay, this room sucks because it's such a narrow room. You can't really get away from that guy. You have to just really hope that he slams down, and then you can run in and hit him, or you can just take the hit like that and deal with it. You can lure this one right here. Don't even try to get that item right now. I'll come back for it. This ladder's surprisingly easy to miss. I missed it my first playthrough with my cleric. Bonfire for this area. Well, technically not the last, but the last one that we're going to be using. So that switch turns all of the fire statues off of the entire area. And if we look out here, we can kind of see where a boss fight may or may not occur. And I'm gonna run back to that room, try to make that jump. Oh crap, I just respawned everybody. Okay, well, I'm gonna go level up and I'll be back. fall back. That was handy. I guess he can't fall back on the guillotine. Maybe. Yeah, and all these fire drake stones. For a game with such exact hitboxes on enemies, the environmental hitboxes are terrible. And it seems like your arrows always get stuck and hit the environment, whereas theirs don't. Guess how many more we get? That's all for now. Okay. I don't think there's anything over here. Trying to remember before I jumped to my death if there's anything tricky about this, because that oh, I have to lower this down, so I know there ain't no way I'm gonna make that jump. Come on, Archer. That one. So fast. It's basically a Hail Mary swing. Like you're anticipating that they use one specific attack, and if they do, then you get it, and if not, then well, too bad. All right, collector. Brahma Bull. Oh, he's got this. He's got the broken Santir spear. There used to be a mimic chest right here. All right. Somebody write my message. So before we fight the boss, we're going to go up to the top of this place. Kind of opposite the bell tower area. And again, this is just... It fills it with water to give you fire resistance, which you really don't need, so save your lockstone. Yes, there are a lot of enemy. I'm surprised I didn't get a backstab there. Somebody give me a boltstone. Let's see if they moved him up here. No, just in case. Oh, the great axe. Okay, so we're up on the roof here, and that bullhead statue is where our bonfire is located, so we're gonna see if we can get down here. Going to drop us off above the cauldron where the knight kind of tried to ambush us. And there's an item on the lip. It's not really too hard to get. I mean, I'm saying that now, watch me fall to my death, but you just have to land on the edge. Okay, well, that gold serpent ring raises our item discovery, so I probably won't really bother with it, unless I'm in areas where I know that there's something that I want in terms of drops. But for now, let's see, we're gonna go ahead and fight this guy. Ooh, I thought I could get a second swing in there. Now let's see what I want to do for this guy. I know I want that fire ring. I think that's probably it. Let me roll with this. It's got a little fire defense. Better than nothing. Oh, let's see. Okay. I get that. And... I'm going to take her. I've soloed this boss. Both times so far. I haven't actually played with the summon yet.
Good day, Hera.
Okay, let's go. This guy's really not too hard. The biggest danger and the thing that's killed me a couple of times is he can knock you off the edge into the lava, and if you fall in the lava, it's, you know, obviously an instant death. So you definitely want to avoid that. He has some big... He basically just beats you with his fist. He has those melee attacks. And he has a fire-breathing attack. He's basically the Balrog from Lord of the Rings. I don't know if that'll... There's a cutscene, so I don't know if it'll kill my Green Blossom effect. Okay. So if you kind of stay away from the walls, or towards the walls, when he swings, doing fire. Oh, he was looking at her. See that? That's how you get killed. You can get knocked off the edge like that. Or almost. I think if I were looking back at him, then I would have... So I'm not even going to bother with the summon this time, but I think if I was looking back at him, I would have seen him rearing back, because I thought he was going to do his fire attack and would give me a second to swig. But anyways. Also, I'm going to try hitting him with magic weapon and stuff. I don't know if I have the ooze. And when he hits the ground like that, it doesn't stagger you, but it kind of like slows you down. Like you can't approach him as fast as you ordinarily can. It's really weird. It's almost like you're walking in like deep water. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and take this stuff off. We'll use dark. Let's see what that does. Come on. Goodbye, Sir King. So yeah, he's... Again, if you know how he kills you, which is basically just knocking you in it, everything he does has a big knockback on it. So obviously with lots of places to get knocked off to your death, it can be kind of tricky. Whoop-de-doo. And we've got our primal bonfire. So this will eventually, I believe, take us to the DLC area. There's nothing you can do in here yet. It'll warp you into a little kind of purgatory type room. So can't do anything just yet. I'm just gonna start dumping some. Let me check what my other dex build has real quick. I don't want to end up going down the exact same path. I want to kind of make this one a little bit different. So let me check that one real quick here.
Proceed. It is the only choice left to you.
Okay. All right, let's see. I think in the next video I'll go sell a bunch of this extra gear to Gavlin in the little poison swamp area, like. And I think, yes, I've got a bunch of duplicate weapons too. Alright, so yeah. That wraps up the Iron Keep. And in the next video, I'm gonna go take care of the Rotten. Use the final of the four old ones. And once we do that, it'll be time to head on up the hill to Dranglet Castle. And I'll be in for a treat because that's a really fun area. Really good looking area. So anyways, I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Appreciate the time. I know this one ran quite a bit longer, so I'll have to see how long it is once I edit it down. But anyways, I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, good day.